We're in the same field of Mr. Fletcher's in Lone Oak County. And in our first video, we talked about cutout and what does it mean. And we spent some time on insect termination. And I thought it would be good for us to go into a little more detail on insect termination. And also, there are some strange things that we see after that that make us second guess ourselves. And I think, Ray, you have a lot of experience in this. And so I would really love you to help us out on this and talk about some of the things that you might see and that you might get scared of. And because we got to have confidence in the data. So again, when we establish our last effective boll population, our last money bolls, then we accumulate heat units on that and we go to degree day calc at uada.edu and look at heat units there. Our Amanda Free sends out a chart. She's been sending that out twice a week. We can look at that and see where we are. Okay, now for tarnished plant bugs, talk about what our cutoff is, and then you know, as we get into the field, say we're 400 heat units here and I'm seeing plant bugs and some of this fruit and all that, you know, what do I need to rethink about sprayer? Or you tell us about what you see.
Our recommendations are 250 heat units after cutout or nodes above white flower 5. If the field is relatively clean of plant bugs, then we can stop worrying about them. The thing that people really need to keep in mind is the plant's going to continue to grow and put young fruit on, and it's going to attract plant bugs. You're going to see a lot of them.
But that fruit's not going to be making us money.
Correct.
Okay.
And in some ways, it can attract them away from fruit that you can harvest. So the visual appearance of all the insects you can see after this point, if you're not careful, can make you second guess. Yeah. But I don't know that we have tested anything any more than this before. It's got a solid research base, and I have all the confidence in it.
Yeah. As Rogers Leonard in Louisiana and people in the Southeast, there are a lot of people looked at the termination for plant bug, and a lot of times they did that in a cage study where that was the only fruit they had opportunity to feed on, and everybody's really comfortable with 250, aren't we?
Yes, they are.
Okay, so when you go in a field that's say 450, 500 heat units after cutout and you see plant bugs out there, friend or foe, they may be more friend because they're knocking some of that fruit off. It's stealing energy from the bolls that are going to be making you money, right?
Correct.
Okay. All right. So maybe that'll help some on plant bugs. Okay. Let's shift focus. You know, you talked about bollworm and bollweevil. We don't have bollweevil anymore. So our big thing right now at 350 is bollworms.
Correct.
So tell us about the threshold and you've gone into fields where we've demonstrated this, where you cleaned them up at 350 and we sprayed some of them several more times. Tell us about some of those experiments.
We never saw a gain in enough yield to justify the cost of control if we continued to control after 350 heat units.
Okay.
We would see damage. Tugwell talked about it, phantom damage. It's damage on fruit that we're not going to harvest. And it looks bad, and it will make you second guess, but the rules hold up.
Oh, you did a lot of fields, and some you sprayed one additional time after 350, some I know you sprayed two times. Did you ever spray any three times?
Yes.
Three times. And so I know I've heard Gus talk about this when he walked into, when we first started doing this, walked into a field that we terminated 350 heat units, and we saw big old worm hiney sticking out those bolls in the top. Maybe those were the phantom bolls, but they were out there, and it just made his heart stop beating, thinking, okay, we cost this grower some money. But then those are the phantom bolls, aren't they?
Right.
So how did yields turn out on those?
We did this over, in one season, 19 fields in the state, and we only asked for fields that would be challenging. It had a lot of insect pressure. And then people replicated this in other states, and we never gained enough yield to pay for an application, never.
Okay. And I know there was a couple places where even with the worm damage in those, say, phantom bolls at the top, they still produced more cotton than the ones that you sprayed two and three more times, right?
It was not uncommon that happened.
But anyway, so that's, you got to have faith in the data, and then try not to second guess yourself, because it does make you very nervous when you come out here and your farmer sees worms in those bolls and wants to fire you right then.
Right.
It's
tough to stick to it sometimes when you see it.
Okay. And stink bugs, really, we don't have a lot of issues with stink bugs, do we?
Not like some of the other pests, but the heat unit rules still apply with them too.
Okay. Then defoliators, how many heat units? You say 500?
I can't remember if it's 500 or 600.
Yeah, 500. What's the, we got fall armyworms and I think of spider mites. There's other things that can cause us damage to defoliators. Why do we need leaves on the plant?
We still need some leaf area to finish filling out some of the bolls.
Yeah, because these younger leaves on the plant, these are, when a cotton leaf gets about 50 to 60 days old, it's ready for retirement. It's still there, it still looks okay, but it's not doing much work. The younger leaves are the ones that are doing all the work. So we got those young leaves all on the outside of the plant that are doing all the heavy lifting to make the plant energy or make sugar. So we want that sugar factory running as long as we can to fill out those bowls. And then you talked about defoliation.
Yeah, our rules on defoliation, a boll is mature enough that it can be defoliated at 850 heat units.
Okay, is that the only criteria you use when you defoliate a field?
It's always, to me, the best start.
Yeah, it tells me when to get in the field to start looking.
And then you look at percent open. If you want more confidence, slice some bowls and get some ideas. But generally, 850 is going to get you at least in the ballpark to where you can start trying to time defoliation.
Sometimes, especially on some of these really green, lush fields, a sharp knife is, and knowing how many heat units I have, and a sharp knife is my best indicator. Okay, now then, the tricky question, irrigation termination. There are a ton of factors that go into that. I've gone into fields where I take a soil probe and go 3 foot deep and have really good soil moisture, a lot of cotton roots. We can terminate irrigation on those. Some of the research says as early as 350 heat units after cutout. But I've been in some fields where we had a lot of nematodes, we had compaction, we had hot weather like today, and some of those have gone to almost 600 heat units. A lot of times when you look at the long-term data in Arkansas, September water just hardly ever pays because we're running out of heat.
Right.
Because when we turn that calendar out of September into October, our heat units drop off really fast. And so we don't have enough heat units to mature. So even if we water and we try to make the bowls, we don't have enough heat units to mature them out. So about the only thing that does, doesn't really make us much cotton, but it costs us time getting a picker in the field. But I think most fields that I look at, somewhere around the 500 heat unit mark is when we, 500 to 550 heat units is about when that cut out.
Very fair estimate.
But I find nodes above white flower, or heat units beyond cutout, is kind of a difficult tool to use by itself to terminate irrigation. But those are things that we can do and things that maybe we can't do or that we would like to do, but maybe one of these days we can, that we can use on our more specific heat unit termination guidelines. So I hope this second video is kind of an addendum to our cutout, what does that mean, is helpful in tying everything together on how to get out of this crop to optimize yield and optimize earliness and hopefully have a positive impact on profitability, right?
Correct.
Okay, thank you.